Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular Stock Chart component to an Angular application. I will also show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like crosshairs and tooltips. The Angular Stock Chart is used to visualize the stock price of any company over a specific period. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I will create my app using the Angular CLI command. I will use VS Code as the editor and show the output in the Chrome browser. In the VS Code, I install the CLI tool globally using the command npm install global at Angular CLI. Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name my Angular project. I'll be asked to add Angular routing. I enter no. And I choose CSS as the stylesheet format. Then I navigate to the project location. To start using the stock chart component, I install the charts package using the command ng add at Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Charts. Before going any further, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license key. Starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release, the license key is mandatory for Angular products to avoid a licensing warning. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. Next, navigate to the App Module page, where you will find the stock chart module imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Charts package and registered in the imports array of the ng module. Here I need only stock chart module and remove other modules. In the style.css file, the material theme styles were added for the Angular products. In the app.component.html file, I replace the default code snippets with the Angular stock chart component using the EJS stock chart tag. Let's see how to display the chart with single candle series. As you know, the charts component is segregated into feature modules. To add a candle series, I need to import the candle series service module from the charts package and inject it into the providers array. In the app component page, I add the eStockChartSeriesCollection tag to define one or more series. Then I add an eStockChartSeries tag to define a series. Set the series type to candle. And set the name to Apple Incorporated. Let me now explain how to populate a stock chart with data points to visualize the price movements in a stock. In this application, I'm going to show Apple stock price in the stock chart with a candle series. I add the data.ts file and define the JSON object as chart data with fields like open, high, low, and so on. In the app component ts page, import this chart data from the data.ts file and assign it to the data variable. In the app component html page, I assign the chart data to the datasource property of the series. Now I need to map fields from the JSON object to the chart series. I assign this date field from the chart data to the x-axis using the xName property. Since the datasource field names are the same as the property names in the field settings, you don't need to map them. If you have different field names, then you need to explicitly map the fields here. Since I have used the date value here, I open the app module page and import the datetime service from the EJ2 Angular Charts package, and inject it to the provider's array. Let me run this application using the command ngserve. See the stock chart rendered. In this candle series, you'll notice that some rectangles are filled while others are left unfilled, as the closing and opening prices vary based on the time. In the toolbar, you have the option to change the series types. To change the indicator, select any option from here. Click this dropdown to change the trend line and select any period from these options. Now, let me demonstrate how to set the title for the chart. I have the title property of stock chart and set its value as Apple stock price. You can see the candle series chart displaying the title Apple stock price. Next, I'll show you how to enable crosshair lines to display the axis values. I declare the variable crosshair settings and add the property enable and set its value as true to display the vertical and horizontal crosshair line. Then assign this variable to the crosshair property. I open the app module page and import the crosshair service from the Angular Charts package and inject it into the provider's array. Look at the candle series chart output showing vertical and horizontal crosshair lines indicating the x-axis and y-axis values of the data point. Also, I can enable the crosshair tooltip to show x-axis values. So, first, let me define the variable x-axis and add the crosshair tooltip property and set the enable property as true. Assign this variable to the primary x-axis property. See, the crosshair tooltip is shown for the x-axis. If I want to show more information about the data points, then I need to enable the tooltip property. To add a tooltip to the chart and range selector, I will import the tooltip service and range tooltip service from the charts package and inject them into the provider's array. I'll declare the variable tooltip options and set the enable property as true. Assign this variable to the tooltip property. And now you can see the tooltip for every data point displaying additional information about the data points of the chart. By default, the range selector is enabled in stock chart, so that you can select a particular range of data points from a large collection of data. If you want to like to hide this range selector, set the enable selector property to false. See the chart now, the range selector is not shown. In this video, I showed you how to configure the Syncfusion Angular Stock Chart component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Charts package. I also showed you how to configure a few of the control's basic features. You can download the working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.